Hello everybody, welcome back once again to the Divinity walkthrough. We are hanging out in Brachus's room here. Obviously the last video there we took him down. And I'm gonna teleport here to the end of time, and we're gonna have some dialogue right away with Zigzax.
You're both here once more. Can you guess what's happened? Surely by now you know the signs. Or perhaps you can simply guess from how utterly giddy I am. Take a look. All your work has not been for naught. This last star stone you discovered has given the weaver just what she needed to mend another portion of the tapestry. Another tantalizing tidbit of long-lost history awaits us. Another piece of your story is ours to discover. Oh, how very thrilling.
For millennia, the Godbox was flanked by the two devoted guardians. But Astarte's playmate, a creature called the Trife, turned her attention to the forbidden box. I may know a way to destroy what's inside, hissed the scheming creature. Together, we can set the guardians free. Open its lid, Astarte, and we can have a look together. Astarte trusted her friend and assented. She pitied the guardians and welcomed a chance to free them. Let me help you, she whispered into the ear of one. I know your duty, but you both deserve a chance at freedom. Haven't you suffered enough of this chore? She asked the other. Look, your companion is free already. The guardians, unaccustomed to such attention, started. She had planted a seed of curiosity within them, rekindled a desire that had, for eons, lain dormant. Slowly, they glanced at one another, and the Trife's trap was sprung.
Magnificent. Oh, truly wondrous. I feel like a prisoner set free. Free to bask in the daylight once more. I was so fearful. Petrified almost in the knowledge that I might see him again. You see, I knew the Mad King. In fact, I served him. I'm a wizard hunter, and that means I've seen many centuries pass me by. They weren't always happy ones, and you may take that as an understatement. I was once under Brachus's thrall, bound to him by perfidious magic. Life was an endless cycle of servitude, torture, and humiliation. Only after the first source hunter skewered him like the pig he was did my nightmare end. As you can imagine, I was afraid beyond all measure that the fiend would enslave us all once more. That I'd be cast back into the rank pit that was my past. But he hasn't, and he never will. Thank you. I will never forget this act of valor. You have foiled one of Leandra's vile designs. That much is certain. But I highly doubt you forestalled her endgame, whatever that may be. It is therefore imperative that we find her sister Ikara. As you've learned from the accursed duo that was Jake and Evelyn, the White Witch is somehow involved. I will vouch for her gentle nature, but alas, I cannot vouch for her current state of mind. Has she been corrupted by her sister, perhaps? Or have they become enemies locked in a murderous game of cat and mouse? There's no way of knowing until you find her. What I do know is that she lives in a cabin deep in Lakula Forest to the north. If anywhere, that is where I advise your travels should take you next. So you have heard of her? Yes. I knew Cassandra. She was a sweet girl when we met. Hardly a woman yet. The very opposite of her deranged brother, who did not hesitate to butcher her for his own benefit. We were fast friends in those days. Aye, more than friends. Until he took her down to the dungeons, and she returned a woman no longer. A twisted lich had she become, with a twisted mind to match her grisly new shape. He remorselessly and relentlessly sought ways to cheat death. Cassandra and he were soul forged, so he knew that if she would die, he would die. And so he turned her into a lich. Turned her into a creature neither living nor dead, so that he could break the soul forge without destroying himself in the process. Giving the matter no further thought, he rid his sister of her humanity, so as to rid himself of a spell that could threaten him. Such a man was Bracchus Rex. Immortal in his mind, and immortal to be in effect. As your swords and spells have demonstrated, though, to this world's everlasting contentment, his deranged fancy was not to be. I don't know. When the Source Hunters besieged Brax's castle, I sought only to escape. I never heard of her again. Yes, I longed for freedom, for release. When I saw my chance, I ran and never looked back. Very well, Hunter. My gratitude is yours, as is my service.
That's it. Bracchus Rex is dead. The way he spoke about our forebears was horrific. I wonder how many Source Hunters had to die before the Source King was deposed. Even if it was one, it was too many. My heart shrivels in my chest when I think of the lust in his voice as he recalled his crimes. Every inch of this Source cult that we unravel is an inch of justice for those killed. Damn Bracchus and all his breed. Damn them straight to hell.
Okay, so wow, there was a ton of dialogue there, and we've got even more coming up. But I went with the, what was that? I think that ended up being, yeah, the romantic trait there for that last dialogue option. Yeah, gosh, I feel like I don't even want to jump into discussing anything because we're going to have more dialogue here.
Master. Other elementals lie in wait until with a word you command them to action. Which one? And that is your final choice?
Yes, it is. Yes, indeed. That...
Thy will be...
Okay, I'll sneak some in here quick. So this is going to look strange if you've been watching the whole playthrough back-to-back because I already unlocked the Earth Elemental Guardians. Room.
How I rejoice at the sight of your growth, both in power and in prowess. And yet I cannot help but wonder, will it ever be enough? Will you craft yourselves once more into the warriors that you were? Oh, in the end, you are like infants still. Infants that would perish with a broken wail had they not their mother's milk to suckle. But you always were like children, weren't you? As are we all in the eyes of the gods. And yet they set an impossible task before you, then blamed you when you failed. How foolish even the divines can be. How lacking in compassion.
I do feel like a child, being kept in the dark about so many things. I guess we'll have to find more Starstone and grow up.
Thank you.
The spirit of Father Nature came to me in a dream last night, and he told me to welcome you. Can't you tell? I'm the universe. You're the universe. We're all the universe. It's a beautiful thing, to be sure. I noticed you were bringing this place in close contact with the spirit of nature, and I thought to myself, that's where I belong. Thanks for putting me up. With utmost pleasure, my friend. The Earth's knowledge is meant to be shared.
Okay, so like I was saying, I had already unlocked the Earth Elemental Room in one of my... Or in, like, my original playthrough, unfortunately, you know, I had to restart my game and so on and so forth. So I chose my elemental room order a little bit differently this time around. I think I went with air first, I think, and then fire, I believe, was the second, and then now I've finally unlocked the earth. So we'll get to the, oh boy, what is the last one then? Earth, air, water, I guess it would be? It must be water. Yeah. And then here I'm going to chat with the Weaver.
How might I serve our mission? Ask and I shall answer, if I can.
Okay, I guess, yeah. I was trying to see here if she had anything to say, like, interesting, but that doesn't seem to be the case.
I hope your quest fares well, dear hunter.
Okay, anyways, all right, so Zigzags... has, you know, some theories
what
as
would you
to...
Like to know?
I don't even remember what's going on now. I don't... He's had so many, like, random weird dialogues that I don't remember all of them. Boy, okay, so the last... Actually, last Zigzags dialogues, excuse me, wasn't very much. It was really just him saying that another piece of the tapestry had been mended... in which it is explained that the creature convinced Astarte that the guardian should be free, and so Astarte, you know, whispers to the guardians, and yeah, I don't know, it says something like they, you know, they look at each other and that was all it took or something, you know, I don't know. I'm not quite understanding that part of it, but, anyway, so the, I almost forgot. So Arhu's got a bit of dialogue there too. Actually, we might have to get to that after Selenia here.
Divines doubly bless you, friend. I shall be very glad to share what information I can give you, by all means. For 2 years, all news has been bad news, and clearly nothing has changed. More dead, more undead, and more letters to write home to grieving widows and widowers. Still, I thank you for telling me, Source Hunter. Knowledge is better than uncertainty.
So I just checked in here with Selenia regarding... Oh, which one was it? Was it to the north of town there where we took care of the burning legion, I guess?
Beyond these walls,
I think that's what unlocks that bit of... I think it's just a little bit of experience there where you kind of just explain what happened. I'm sorry. I think that's the cemetery area. I think so, anyway. All right. Arhu, obviously, thanking us for the defeat of Bracchus Rex, and he does talk a little about Cassandra, and we will be running into her a bit later, and I should say, you know, a little bit more of her story will be explained later. Obviously, he was, and I don't know if that was the first time they had explained it or brought the whole Soul Forge up. So, It was explained that, actually, I think maybe Brachus himself had explained that him and his sister were soul-forged, meaning that if one of them was killed, the other one was killed. So, he was obviously saw that as a weakness, and so he thought up a way to kind of make it so it didn't matter, like, if Cassandra had died, and so he turned her into a lich, I think is what the... How they say it. I've always said lich in all of my years of gaming, and, you know, who knows, I've probably been wrong for, you know, whatever, 20 years. But, yeah, anyways, it always seems weird to say things in a different way than what I've used to. You know, a lot of times, and especially when it comes to RPGs, you know, I played so many when I was a kid and didn't know how to pronounce certain words, I'm sure, correctly, and thus, you know, things stick that way, and then it's difficult to, you know, to change your ways. So, yeah, if it sounds funny, if I, you know, say lich, well, that's why. But anyways, all right, so this, Incandescent Wanderer? I thought incandescent was like,
I'm overheating here.
Kind of like ethereal, like see-through, without having, you know, a solid form. I don't know. Seems like a very strange title for that enemy. Anyways, when you kill it here, it looks like it's left some lava on the ground. So I don't know. I think eventually it goes. Oh, there, did it just go away? I think it just did. Yeah, I think it just went away. Okay. It didn't have anything that I was interested in anyway, so I didn't bother walking over there and picking it up. But and then here we've got a zombie troll, I think, here, and then it's poisonous friend. And so we're just gonna jack them up a bit. Long dead troll. Okay. I forgot that my main character's got Tenebrium wands now, so I wasn't able to. To light the ground on fire. But there we go. Alright. Yeah, these guys aren't going to live very long. So this area just leads back towards the cemetery. So if you've already been through here, well, this is kind of how it links up. And I just wanted to make sure that I had explored everything completely. So as far as Sisile goes, though, this might be it. I think this is the last little bit of Sisile that I needed to explore.
What a deluge.
Ah! Here, I just got lazy and just started walking through the poison. There's an area, it's coming up in a few videos, where I kind of do the same thing. I realized that, like, one of my probably my main character, I don't know, her resistances aren't that great, but I just, you know, between having a decent amount of HP and a healing spell and then the rain spell, she can kind of just take care of herself. So I was just kind of bulldozing through areas where, you know, or like areas that had traps in them. And I was like, yeah, whatever. So it was kind of nice for a change. Every other time I've played on tactician mode, I've been pretty much on level. So it's harder to do certain things like that, and some of the puzzles get a little tedious, just because you know, you just have to be careful, and like one wrong step here or there can mean, you know, exploding and getting your party killed. So it's kind of nice to put in a little time there at Maradino's lab, get a little over leveled or a lot over leveled in my case, and then, you know, kind of be able to just plow through stuff without dying constantly. But that, you know, that's tactician mode for you. So I got what I asked for, that's for sure. But all right, so like I said, I believe this is completely it for Sisile. We have done I'm sure there's definitely some loose ends, like Blasius's will, and we'll take care of that eventually, but for the most part, Sisile is completely done. And so we will be, I mean, again, we'll come back probably, you know, here and there for random stuff, but for the most part, Sisile is complete, which feels pretty good. I feel like, you know, what is this? This is probably around the 50th video. Granted, a few of them actually have been here in Lucullo Forest, grant, you know, like I said. So, like, the Maradino's Lab, I did two kind of, like, power leveling guides for that. Although I don't know if power leveling is quite the right term now that I think about it. It probably just should have been Maradino's Lab leveling guide. Power leveling assumes that, you know, you've got a more powerful character or, you know, some person helping you to
Did
level.
You see that?
So, I don't know. Again, maybe power leveling wasn't the right way to name the guide, but hey, I did it. So, it's done now. And now I have to deal with it. Alright, so we're going to head towards the White Witch's cabin, I believe. Obviously, this is not the first time I've been to Lucullo. I've already, got a few of the merchants and unlocked... Yeah, actually, I've unlocked quite a bit of this area.
Ah, the Source Hunter. It is my greatest pleasure to announce to you that we Immaculates have captured the feared White Witch and quarantined her House of Horrors. Yes, the greatest known threat to Rivalon has been neutralized. Thanks in no small part to you, Source Hunter. Your activities in Sisile drove the snake to her den, and that's where we Immaculates sprang our trap. I am a proud Immaculate, sworn to use my summoner's expertise in service of the goddess's one way and the greater good. The High Counselor of Sisile. We mourned his tragic death. Yes, every Immaculate honors the memory of that noble man. Still, Source Hunter, I am sworn on my life to guard this quarantine. I serve a higher authority than yours and will not waver in my duty.
Okay, so I've got a little, option here with this summoner to charm him. I think I failed the first time. Yeah. So I'm going to reload my game here. And there should be a cut right here. Bloop. There we go. So I went with the intimidate option, actually.
I heard your kind could be particularly persuasive. Go on then, Source Hunter. But please, tell no Immaculate I let you pass, or it will be my life.
It's kind of funny how many of the Immaculates you can intimidate into letting you pass.
What's that?
These void crystals? I have no idea what these are for, to be honest. Like, I just don't remember. I think, though, that there is a way that you can start a battle up here. There's these goofy mushroom things that we will talk to, and I know you can kill them. And so I don't know if these void crystals help out during that battle or something. I don't know. But yeah, I just destroyed them. I didn't want to deal with them. And then here's a waypoint. Got a bunch of experience and somebody leveled up there. That's my henchman. My henchman Ambrosia, who appears to have her weapons out. I don't know why.
I sung of chaos and eternal night, taught by the heavenly muse to venture down the darkest descent and up to reascend. Excuse us. We had something lodged in our windpipe. Oh, somehow we doubt that very much. Have you ever seen the Moth King's silver spoon? Nearly microscopic. No, Source Hunter. We do believe this life hasn't finished surprising you. Not in the least.
It's quite a lovely sort of barrier, isn't it? Who doesn't enjoy a gentle, breezy motion against one's backside after all? Then again, we suspect it's been hoisted up by some not-so-savory characters. And we happen to know just how to remove it. The only trouble is finding the right sort of clever sort of intrepid sort of person to entrust such a secret to. Here's what we propose. We've a fresh batch of 3 brain teasers hot off our thinking caps. Perhaps if you can answer them correctly, we might find you spirited enough to entrust with the barrier's deepest, darkest secrets. But it isn't all fun and games. We hardly offer second chances to the beriddled. If you give us a single false answer, we'll clam up like morning glories at midnight. So, do you have what it takes? This is better news than the Orc Queen misplacing her thumbscrew. But enough delays. Let us begin. Your first riddle begins thus. The ravenous brute tore down my chartreuse gown, ripped out my silken hair by its roots, wrenched my children from me, and fed me to the hogs. Who am I?
An ear of corn. That's right. An ear of corn fits perfectly.
Bravo! Bravo! Bravissimo! An ear of corn indeed. Can you imagine a sheep in a chartreuse gown? A pumpkin with silken hair? The fantasies of a fool. Now, on to our second riddle. And this one's sure to stump you. I cannot lie, I cannot lay, but only lie. Who am I?
A stone. That's right. A stone fits perfectly.
You've done it again. I'm thrilled. I'm amazed. I'm liable to present the very last riddle. This one will blow you out of your stockings. So hold on tight. I've a neck as long as twice the width of a toad's tail. As many eyes as half the number of seasons per annum. I'm known to cause hurricanes in the Far East merely by taking off 2 minutes too late. Who am I?
You tried to solve that riddle, puffed away in a small impish huff, mumbling about space-time. But not you. You stuck it out until the very end, you crafty little so-and-so. So, what would you like to know? One thing we know for certain. This barrier doesn't belong here. The wizard Maradino knew as much when he started poking around here. He developed a spell to remove it, but his fancy was caught elsewhere before he bothered to implement it. Down the spell dropped, and up we scooped it. Unfortunately, we aren't quite human enough to get it to work. But you've proven yourself just the right sort of clever sort of intrepid sort of person we'd love to entrust such a secret to. We thought you'd never ask. What would you like to know? Some call her the Guardian of Lucula. And by our estimations, she's more than earned the title. She's a healing witch, concerned mostly with the safety of the living souls, animals and plants alike, of this forest. And she's been here since even before our great-great-great-great-grandmother, Francisca Toadstool the 44th, can recall. We've long lodged adjacent to her little cabin, and she used to greet us with a "How do you do?" every morning. We do hope she's not entangled in anything unsavory. What a shame it'd be if someone with a penchant for heavy-handed hoe-wielding moved in. Murder? That doesn't sound like her at all, no. Much more interested in patching things up than tearing them down, that one. Then again,
It's hard to tell on what stalk a person truly stands until you've seen them at the end of their rope. Isn't that so? We suppose if someone held a sword to our caps, we'd fight them with every last spore we had. Somewhere in her cabin, as far as we know. The last we saw her, she and her apprentice Almina were rushing inside, whispering to one another. They seemed rather anxious. Perhaps they knew that those Immaculates were on their trail. A group of them followed some time after and erected the barrier around the cabin. We haven't seen the White Witch or Almina since. Are you addressing us?
Okay, so the mushrooms give you a little bit more, I don't know if I'd say backstory, I guess it's kind of backstory, but give you a little bit more clue as to what kind of person the White Witch is. And then on top of that, they've got a kind of a fun little, riddle game, I guess. Riddles are always fun. And then this one, it just says the same thing. Yeah, let's get out of here. So I know for sure you can kill them, and I don't know if that'll drop the barrier or not, but I'm gonna go about it a different way, I guess. But I don't remember the other, what else we had to do. I mean, we're gonna figure out eventually, but if I remember though, I could have swore that you can kill those mushrooms and you can get inside there. But again, we're gonna go about it a different way. Or at least try to. Boy, what else did I want to talk about? I feel like I'm missing something that I had started earlier. Oh, yeah, so the Immaculate Summoner back there that I intimidated into getting out of the way, I think maybe it would have been a better idea to just kill him. Because he just ran off, and so whatever he had on him, obviously I'm not going to be able to get as a drop, so, yeah, I don't know, I'd say maybe it's a better idea to just kill him. As far as experience-wise, though, I'm not sure, because I don't know how much experience you get from the dialogue option, and how much he actually would give you if you, whacked him. So... anyways, alright, so I'm back in Marinino's lab. I don't remember why I stopped in here. There must have been a clue. Maybe the mushrooms had a clue? Lair,
it seems they've long abandoned it by now. It certainly doesn't seem to have been a planned departure, does it?
Doesn't seem. Oh, I can't. Didn't catch what that other character said there. But, alright, so I didn't fully explore Marinino's lab, when I was here. To do all my leveling, so we're gonna do that now. yeah, I don't know, this is mostly just junk, to be honest. Okay, it's time to take a rest, I guess. Cloth scrap, some books, some more books, a chest. Ooh, level 4 lore mess, that's actually a pretty good helmet then. Potentially, it's pretty good. I know there's an area here. Oh, yeah, this is the way. Okay. So, there's an imp back here in this cave, and he is related to, I want to say it's Frederick? I might be getting the name. It's either Frederick or... I'm pretty sure it's Frederick. Anyways, it's the guy that, he's right outside the goblin village. And he's kind of down in a ravine, and he's, like, injured. And he'll say that he needs a bloodstone. And if you have a bloodstone, you can give it to him. Otherwise, you just tell him no, and he'll walk off. Otherwise, the other thing with him, though, is if you start the dialogue with him and then you just leave, and so I think the only way to get that dialogue to work, though, is if you don't have a bloodstone on you and then you talk to him.
I'm overheating here.
And here is Yox, the imp.
Shouldn't have done it. No, 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 bad Yox, bad. No, 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 bad Yox, very bad.
He's the one that injured. So Yox is the one that injured. Was it? Again, I think it's Frederick.
I feel uneasy here. I'd better.
And then here, there's a fight
ready.
Coming up, and I see the bow kit there laying on the ground. That's nice. And then here, I don't know what I was thinking. I thought maybe I could get a jump on this guy, but that's not the case. So I think if you. If you interact with Frederick and you do not have a bloodstone on you, he'll just ask for one. And if you don't have one on you, then you can actually leave, and he'll stay there in the ravine. But the problem is if you wait too long, he'll just die there, which I don't know. I guess isn't the worst thing, because. At least then you'll get to, I think, I don't know if he drops anything, like, I don't know if he has anything on him, but that would mean that he would drop, you know, whatever he's got. On the flip side, though, if you have a bloodstone and you refuse to give him one, he'll just walk off. I don't know if you can kill him as he's walking off, because at least that way you could get a little bit of experience from him, and, I mean, you could get his drops as well, so I may try to explore that option. But the third option is to actually just give him a bloodstone. The problem with doing that is you just literally lose one. He walks off with it and you never get it again. And that is way more detrimental, I would say, than anything else, because you need those bloodstones to open up your rooms in the homestead. So, again, I would say don't give him one. I don't think it's worthwhile at all. And there, like I said, there doesn't seem to be any real advantage in giving him one. So, so that's the Rafflesia. I think I'm saying that right. Maybe I am. Maybe I'm not, though. That one's not too tough of a battle. And then we've got the bow kit here, part two, I guess. To be honest, I'm not using any of those weapons, the ones that you can kind of upgrade as you go. I just don't find them all that useful. And come to think of it, I don't know that I've ever used any of those weapons. But maybe they are good. Here's the key to the study, which I didn't realize is here. So if you haven't completely explored Meridino's lab and you haven't got into the study area, that's where the key is at. So it's kind of funny. In my leveling guide, I, you know, talk about using the magical unlock skill, and then I had to correct myself because you actually don't need that. You can literally teleport someone in past the gate using the teleportation skill. So you don't need, again, like I said, you don't need the key at all, and you don't need a magical unlock scroll either. You can, like I said, literally just teleport yourself right inside the room, so... Alright, that is all we've got time for, though. I'm running extremely long on this video. So, as always, hope the guide was helpful, and hope you join me for more videos. Thanks for watching. Beware of the lost ones.